Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Averie, and today I'm going to be talking about all of the books that I read in November. So I ended up reading 11 books in the month of November, and I DNF'd 2. I ended up not physically reading a single book, like completing. The only physical book on this list is a book that I DNF'd. I didn't get a lot of physical reading done in the month of November. I listened to a lot of audiobooks, and I actually read a lot of more ebooks than I normally do, so I'm going to be talking about those books right now. We're going to start out with all of the books that I read during the Buzzwordathon. I will link my reading vlog down below for y'all. The Buzzwordathon is a week-long readathon hosted by Books and Lala, and this round with Gabby Reads. This is where you try to read books that have a specific word in the title, and this round was numbers, so you read books that have numbers in the title. So I'm going to be going through these books briefly because I did do a TBR video about them and I did a whole reading vlog reading these books, so I'm going to briefly talk about the books in this grouping. Let's get the books that I did not finish out of the way. We have Once Upon a Prince by Rachel Houck. This is a royalty romance book involving Christian faith also, which at the point that I decided to give up reading this, Christian faith hadn't really been discussed with the main characters all that much, so I didn't know how it was going to be interwoven into this story. This book was just really, really boring to me and nothing was happening at all, and I found it very unrealistic when it came to the prince royalty aspect to it, so that is why I did not finish this book. Next we have The Hot One by Lauren Blakely. I started this one randomly while going to the grocery store towards the end of the week and ended up not finishing it because I didn't really care about the characters. I don't really remember anything about it. I think it's a second chance romance book. That's all I know about it. I just knew that at the end of the Buzzwordathon, I was gonna start up my Black Dagger Brother audiobook. So I ended up just not finishing it. I returned it to Audible Escape. So that's all I have to say about that one because I don't know anything about it. I ended up completing 3 audiobooks for the Buzzwordathon. First one is One Ride by Chelsea Cameron. This is my first motorcycle club romance book. This is about our main character named Delilah, or Doll, and she is the daughter of the president of a motorcycle club. She receives a threat, like a mobster threatens her, so her father decides to put her on the back of the bike of Trip, who is a part of the Hellions, which is the motorcycle club, and puts her on the back of the bike with Trip to take her to a faraway place so no one can find her and can't be threatened anymore. This is a romance between Trip and Doll. I really enjoyed the steamy scenes. They were very well written. The only issue that I have, the main issue that I had, was that I didn't get a lot into the motorcycle club at all, and the big threat that happened with Doll, we did not see that at all. And I wanted to see that. It was just randomly resolved. The ending was also very abrupt. Be sure to check out my reading vlog for all these books in this grouping to know my in-depth thoughts to it though. Next we have 10 Tiny Breaths by K.A. Tucker. These are about our 2 main characters named Casey and Trent. It's their romance together, and Casey is basically running away from a troubled past. She moves across the country and falls for her neighbor named Trent. I read this book and was really enjoying it, and then when I finished it, there were some things that I was not okay with, so I ended up giving this book a 2 out of 5 stars, which is very disappointing for a K.A. Tucker book for me. I've always given her books 3.5 or higher. To know my reasoning why I didn't like this book in depth, be sure to go check out the reading vlog. There were just some things that I was not okay with in the end of the book, and I felt very uncomfortable about. Next in this grouping is Punk 57 by Penelope Douglas. I ended up giving this book 5 stars. I loved it. I believe I listened to this one through Audible Escape as well. This is about our 2 main characters named Ryan and Misha, and when they were in 5th grade, they were forced to become pen pals for a school assignment. They've never met each other before, and it is years later. I believe they are seniors in high school, and Misha ends up not writing to Ryan for like 3 months. She has no idea why, and you figure out why in this book, and they end up meeting, but not really meeting, if that makes sense. This is kind of problematic, but I really enjoyed that. I knew going into it that it was going to be problematic, so I really enjoyed the story. And again, for my in-depth thoughts and feelings, go check out that reading vlog. And lastly, in my Buzzwordathon grouping, we have It Takes 2 to Tumble by Kat Sebastian. I ended up not finishing this during the Buzzwordathon, but I finished it like a week later. This is an LGBTQ gay historical romance book, which I loved. I gave this book 4 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed it. This is about Ben, who is a vicar, and him falling for Philip, who is the captain of a navy vessel. Philip is a single father, and Ben basically helps tutor his kids. I thought of it as a gay version of The Sound of Music, but without music involved. I really, really, really enjoyed this. The relationship between Philip and Ben was wonderful to read about. I really loved their characters and their romance together. It's very difficult for them, obviously, in that time period, so it's kind of hard to read at certain parts, but overall, I really enjoyed my time reading this one. Books that I did not read during the Buzzwordathon. We have Before I Ever Met You by Karina Halley. This is a romance between a main character woman who I believe is 25 and I believe her father's best friend named Will. So it's an age gap romance. Our main character woman has a 7-year-old son as well. So she is a single mother and she is in desperate need of a job. So her father helps her get a job with his best friend who is in the same company as her father and becomes Will's assistant. So it's an office romance, age gap romance, kind of forbidden romance because that's her father's best friend. I got this one off of Audible Escape. I ended up giving this one 3 out of 5 stars. I didn't really find anything that special to it. It was just like a okay book, if that makes sense. I honestly don't remember all that much about it. I believe I finished this literally the first day of November. I did really feel like with her being a single mother, our main character woman, I don't remember her name. Her being a single mom, she was really away from her son a lot in this book. That's the thing that I saw a lot in this book that I kept picking up on. So that's all I know about it. So I just gave this one 3 out of 5 stars. It wasn't really that remarkable of a book, if that makes sense. Next, we have another Karina Halley book. We have The Swedish Prince. This is a royalty romance book. I previously read, I think it's called The Nordic King, I think last year or a few years ago, and really loved it. And this is the first book in that companion series. I unfortunately didn't love this one as much as the other one. This is also an Audible Escape if you want to check it out. And this is about Prince Victor, who is Prince of Sweden, and his relationship with Maggie, who is just a small town girl, ends up actually having to take care of her 5 brothers and sisters because her parents were brutally murdered. So she has gained custody of her siblings. It is Victor and Maggie's relationship because Victor is taking a little bit of a hiatus vacation before he has to become king because his brother previously died. So he, Victor, is now the heir to the throne instead of his brother. So it is Maggie and Victor's relationship and the inner workings of that and how a common girl from the United States can have a relationship with the Prince of Sweden. I ended up giving this one 3.5 out of 5 stars. It was okay. There was nothing bad about it per se. I just found issues with the end. It was fine when the book was set in America and everything, but then once they end up having to go to Sweden, and the whole time the book was set in Sweden, I found it very rushed and kind of unrealistic, so I didn't enjoy this one as much as A Nordic King, unfortunately. Next, we have Nadine's Champion by Ruby Dixon. This is book number 8, a part of the Ice Home series. Ice Home is a spinoff of the Ice Planet Barbarians. Ice Planet Barbarians and Ice Home is a series all about women who end up crash landing on this deserted ice planet full of blue aliens, most of them men, and it's about them finding their lifelong mate and partner. And each book is about a different character and their love interest. This one is about Nadine and her love interest. I don't remember his name. There are so many alien character names. I ended up giving this one actually a 3 out of 5 stars. This was definitely not my favorite out of all of the books. Main reason was I didn't really like our mailman character. He has this quality. He likes to be very, very, very competitive, and he's competitive over everything that he does. I found that very annoying at times, just like him wanting to compete and be competitive in like things you shouldn't do that with. I just found it very annoying, and I was like, girl, Nadine, like, how can you put up with this? Like, you gotta, like, call him out, and she never did. I got this one off of Kindle Unlimited as well. All of the Ice Home and Ice Planet Barbarian books are on Kindle Unlimited, and I really love this series and will always read an Ice Home and Ice Planet Barbarian book. Next, we have Trick by Natalia Jaster. This is a fantasy new adult romance book that I read with Ashley and Jen for the Lovely Ladies Book Club. I will leave our live show linked down below where we talked about this book in depth and what we thought about it. This is a romance between a princess and a neighboring kingdom's jester, and it's very forbidden. The writing style is very difficult to get into for some people. me and Jen. It was kind of difficult to read. I got this one also off of Kindle Unlimited, if you're interested. I ended up giving this book 3.75 out of 5 stars because there were certain aspects of this book that I really loved and one character that I absolutely adored, but I can't tell you about them because it would be a spoiler to talk about them. And there is disability rep that is so well done in this book, and I've never read a fantasy book that has disability rep in it, like a full-on fantasy novel that has disability rep like this. It's so good in that aspect. If you want to know my issues and my critiques about the book and everything, be sure to go check out that live show. Jen and Ashley and I go very in-depth on what we thought about the book. And lastly, we have our last three books, which did not come as a surprise. We have the next books in the Black Dagger Brotherhood series and the first book in the Black Dagger Legacy series. I also listen to all of these on Libby through my library. We have The King by J.R. Ward. This is book number 12. Book number 12 in the Black Dagger Brotherhood. This is about Wrath and Beth mainly, and they're going through some struggles. So I loved reading this one. Next, we have book number 13. There's so many books in this series. The Shadows by J.R. Ward. This is about our shadow brothers in here, Trez and Iam. I love them a lot. This is the first book in the series that I've actually cried while reading. This was great, wonderful. I gave both of these 5 out of 5 stars for freaking sure. The audiobooks are so good. And the next book and last book on this list is Blood Kiss by J.R. Ward, and it is a part of the Black Dagger Brotherhood spin-off series, Black Dagger Legacy. So I've decided to read all of the Black Dagger Brotherhood books, Black Dagger Legacy. I'm reading them in publication order. So that's why I read this one before the next book in the Black Dagger Brotherhood, which is The Beast, which is my current read. This is about our main character named Paradise, who is a vampire. She is like a vampire aristocrat, basically. And it's about her getting into a training program of the Black Dagger Brotherhood and her falling for another trainee named Craig, but he is basically like a vampire commoner, and it's very frowned upon for an aristocrat to be with a vampire commoner. It's about them dealing with their feelings and falling for each other, even though they know they shouldn't. I loved this book. I ended up giving this one 4 out of 5 stars just because I didn't love this one as much as the Black Dagger Brotherhood books, but I really enjoyed it nonetheless. Anyways, there you have it. Those are all of the books that I read in the month of November. I hope to read a lot more in December. Hopefully I will physically read a bunch more in December. Be sure to leave a comment down below whether or not you have read some of these books or if you plan to. But anyways, thank y'all so much for watching, and I'll see y'all soon in the next one. Bye!